The Emperor Qianlong passed away at 89. During his life, he totally had about 50 emperors and concubines, including 3 emperors, 5 imperial noble consorts, 5 noble consorts, 6 consorts, 6 imperial concubines, 12 noble ladies, 4 first-class female attendants, 5 choice ladies, and 2 gege. 9 of them passed away after Qianlong's death. The consort Jing passed away 2 years after Dao Guang became the emperor. The Empress Xiao Xian, the Empress Xiao Yi, the imperial noble consort Zhe Min, the imperial noble consort Hui Xian, and the imperial noble consort Shu Jia were buried with the Emperor Qianlong in the same tube of Yulin. In their tube, there is an empty space for Qianlong's step empress. Because of demotion, the step empress wasn't buried here. All other Qianlong's concubines were buried in consort's tube of Yulin. The Empress Xiao Xian was Qianlong's first wife and empress. They married before Qianlong inherited the throne. They had 2 boys and 2 girls. Only the second girl, known as the Prince He Jin of the first rank, grew up. The Empress Xiao Xian passed away at 36. Qianlong's second empress, Ula Na La Shi, was demoted based on the facts because she cut her hairs. She and Qianlong had 2 boys and 1 girl. Only 1 boy grew up, but was hated by Qianlong. The step empress passed away at 48. The Empress Xiao Yi was Qianlong's third empress. After the step empress was demoted, she managed the inner court as the imperial noble consort until she passed away at 48. She totally gave birth 6 kids for Qianlong, which was the most in Qianlong's inner court. Her son, Yong Yan, inherited Qianlong's throne, known as the Emperor Jia Qing. Xiao Yi was posthumously promoted to the empress. The imperial noble consort Zhe Min, Fu Cha Shi, was Qianlong's gege. She gave birth to Qianlong's first son and second daughter. She passed away 2 months before Qianlong became the emperor. When Qianlong got the throne, he promoted her to the consort. 9 years later, she was promoted to the imperial noble consort Zhe Min. The imperial noble consort Hui Xian, Gao Jia Shi, was Qianlong's gege, then was promoted to the Ce Fu Jin, which is the first rank concubine of the prince. When Qianlong became the emperor, she was promoted to the noble consort. When she was hopelessly sick, Qianlong promoted her to the imperial noble consort. She was Qianlong's first noble consort and the imperial noble consort. Unfortunately, she didn't have any kids. The imperial noble consort Chun Hui, Shu Shi, was Qianlong's gege. She originally was a Han Chinese. When Qianlong became the emperor, she was promoted to the consort Chun. 9 years later, she was promoted to the noble consort. 1 month before that, she was promoted to the imperial noble consort. She gave birth two boys and two girls for Qianlong. The imperial noble consort Shu Jia, Jin Jia Shi, was Qianlong's 格格. Her family was sourced from Korean. When she was alive, her highest rank was noble consort. One day after she passed away, she was promoted to the imperial noble consort. She gave birth four boys for Qianlong. The imperial noble consort, Qing Gong Lu Shi, was a Han Chinese. No records about when she came into the imperial palace. When she was alive, her highest rank was the noble consort. Because the Emperor Jia Qing was raised by her, Jia Qing promoted her to the imperial noble consort. The noble consort Yu, Hai Jia Shi, was Qianlong's 格格. When she was alive, her highest rank was consort Yu. She gave birth to Qianlong's fifth son, Yongqi, who was considered as the crown prince by Qianlong. Unfortunately, Yongqi passed away at 25 in 1766. After that, consort Yu was posthumously promoted to the noble consort. The noble consort Xin, Dai Jia Shi, was Qianlong's consort. She gave birth two daughters for Qianlong, but both of them died at young age. In 1763, she was pregnant. Several months later, she suddenly passed away. After that, Qianlong promoted her as the noble consort. The noble consort Wan, Chen Shi, was a Han Chinese. She was Qianlong's 格格. In 1737, Qianlong promoted her as the noble lady. 12 years later, she was promoted to imperial concubine. Then, until 1794, 1 year before Qianlong retired, she was promoted to consort. In 1801, the Emperor Jia Qing promoted her to the noble consort. The noble consort Wan passed away at 92, who was the longest-lived consort of Qianlong. The noble consort Ying, Ba Lin Shi, was Qianlong's consort. She raised Qianlong's youngest son, Yong Lin, who was born by the Empress Xiao Yi. Jia Qing promoted her to the noble consort. She passed away at 70. The noble consort Xun, Yergen Jue Luo Shi, was Qianlong's consort. She came into the inner court in 1776 as noble lady. Same year was promoted to the noble concubine. In 1794, 1 year before Qianlong retired, she was promoted to the consort. There wasn't records about Qianlong officially promoted her to the noble consort, but in many history documents, she was called the noble consort. The consort Shu Yehe Nala Shi was Qianlong's consort. In 1741, she came into the imperial palace as noble lady. 7 years later, was promoted to the consort. She gave birth to Qianlong's 10th son, but this little prince died at 3 years old without name. In 1775, the imperial noble consort Ding, who was the Empress Xiao Yi, passed away. Consort Shu became the highest-ranked imperial woman. 2 years later, she passed away at 49. The consort Dun Wang Shi was Qianlong's consort. When Qianlong was 64 years old, she gave birth to Qianlong's 10th daughter, known as the Princess He Xiao of the first rank. The Princess He Xiao was Qianlong's favorite daughter, which made consort Dun was favored by Qianlong. 7 years after Qianlong's death, she passed away at 60. The consort Rong He Zhuoshi was Muslim. She came into the imperial palace when she was 25. In folklore, she was called consort Xiang, which means her body naturally produced fragrant. In 1788, consort Rong passed away because of sickness. The consort Yu, Bo Er Ji Ji Te Shi, was Qianlong's consort. She grew up in Mongolia. In 1757, she came into the imperial palace as a maid. 1 year later, she became the noble lady. In 1759, she miscarried. To comfort her, Qianlong promoted her to the noble concubine. 5 years later, she was promoted to the consort and kept in this rank until death. The consort Jin Fu Cha Shi was Qianlong's noble lady. In the imperial election event, she was elected by the Emperor Jiaqing for 88 years old Qianlong. Several years after she came into the inner court, Qianlong passed away. As the late Empress consort, she moved into Shoukang Palace. When Dao Guang became the Emperor, she was promoted to the consort. The consort Fang Chen Shi was a Han Chinese. She was Qianlong's consort. She came into the inner court when she was 15 and became a first-class female attendant. 9 years later, she was promoted to the noble lady. Then after another 19 years, 1 year before Qianlong retired, she was promoted to the noble concubine. Before Qianlong's death, Qianlong promoted her to the consort. Consort Fang passed away 2 years after Qianlong's death. The noble lady Shun, Niu Hulu Shi, was very special. She was from the upper three banner. She came into the imperial palace as noble lady in 1766. 2 years later, she was promoted to the noble concubine. In 1776, she miscarried and then was promoted to the consort. She had a great relationship with Qianlong until 1788. In 1788, the consort Shun was demoted to the noble concubine for unknown reason. 16 days later, Qianlong further demoted her to noble lady. 1 year later, noble lady Shun passed away. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.